Good evening. For the second time in 3 days, the streets of Melbourne have been turned into a war zone, with construction workers storming their own union over mandatory vaccines. Violent clashes are still erupting near the Elizabeth Street headquarters of the CFMEU, police now using rubber bullets to disperse the mob. Reid Butler's there.
This is the moment these tradies turned on their leader. Union boss John Setka forced inside. You can see him here screaming at the protesters to stop. But the efforts are in vain. Crates and bottles are thrown. A member of Setka's staff using a megaphone to try and fend off demonstrators. Security finally managed to jam the doors close. Protesters started gathering at the Elizabeth Street headquarters this morning. Tradies angry the vaccine will be mandatory for the construction sector.
On Tuesday, I won't be able to go to work.
As more gathered, the union leader, who has publicly spoken out against mandating the jab, came out to try and reason with the crowd. But he was shouted down by his members, who by now had been joined by anti-lockdown protesters who've regularly attended illegal rallies in the city.
So you want us to shut the whole building down? Yeah.
He's got it! Inside me.
The Premier today condemned the scenes that would soon get worse.
There'd be a whole bunch of people who are at home because their industry's shut and they'd be scratching their heads about why anyone would be protesting about being open.
As the CFMEU office front was destroyed, police swarmed, guns drawn. Officers able to move the protesters away. The crowd tightly packed near the entrance to Queen Victoria Market, still chanting anti-vax slogans. It's just after 5 o'clock. The union boss is still holed up inside his offices and the protesters have just started marching away from the city up Victoria Street. A huge police presence remains at the intersection of Victoria Street and Elizabeth Street. This was a day of rage and it's likely to continue into the night.
Reid Butler joins us now from Elizabeth Street. Reid, the protesters aren't backing down.
Yes, Pete, it feels a little eerily quiet compared to what it has been here. I mentioned, though, in my package that the protesters were marching up Victoria Street, potentially in the direction of Parliament, but police were able to force them in the other direction, further down Elizabeth Street. We saw some arrests happen down there, some rubber bullets being fired and flares being released as well. Right now, and clearly, as you can see here, some angry scenes still. The crowd has dispersed a little. These guys were part of that gathering earlier and are leaving as the rain sets in. But the other interesting moment that's interesting element to keep a watch on here right now is what's happening out the front of the CFMEU headquarters. A little while ago, I saw some union officials leave and then there were some tense scenes there, some kind of meeting involving a lot of police as well. And there is still a large police presence at the office there and more officers going into the headquarters as well. The CFMEU has released a statement tonight condemning the violence, maintaining that they never supported the mandatory jab anyway, and condemning the right-wing extremists rather that have joined the protests throughout today. The construction industry really is on thin ice when it comes to being shut down altogether. We've seen breaches and the government is concerned about rising infection numbers. The scenes that have unfolded here in the city today, Pete, that is likely to push the construction sector even closer to full closure. So it'll be one to watch very closely in the coming days.
OK, thank you, Reid Butler, on the scene there in Elizabeth Street.